It's been a good few years since we last saw you behind the camera, Peter. What brought you back?
Love the question. Good few years since you last saw me behind the camera. Did you see me behind the camera a few years ago?
Personally, I was there.
I'm lucky in the sense that I have this very glorious diversion known as acting. And the acting thing pays better, less lonely, and you get to the pub a lot earlier. Whereas if you're directing, it's bollocks, it's 24/7 and hard graft. And when you're writing, you just do anything except write, you know, you tidy up. There's only so much tidying up you can do before you have to damn well write.
Well, I mean, after your break, did you find it difficult or even more difficult now to make a film in Britain right now? Is it a bit of a task trying to get money together?
No, we got the money relatively quickly. Had we tried to make the film 6 months later, we'd have been screwed. Because it would literally just as we were cutting the film, that the real impact of the banks and the chaos that they've created before that really hit, I think we'd have struggled then. If we were just starting out raising the money, we'd have had a big problem.
Conor, how grateful are you that your mum reads the local paper?
I'm very grateful, man. Incredibly grateful. I mean, obviously NEDS is the best experience of my life.
And was it your mum? Did she say, "I've read this and go along"? Or was it?
No, it was somebody who knew my dad. Dad had read it and then gave it to my dad. My dad brought it up the road and gave it. Right. I don't know where the mum came into it. I'm truly grateful that I even managed to get a part in the movie and totally loved it. Totally enjoyed it.
What was your first reaction when you actually saw yourself on a big screen? Was it a surreal experience, or had you been used to seeing yourself by that point?
No, it was weird. But I just tried to kind of see it through as if I was watching it, as if it was just another film. Obviously, I wasn't in this, so I tried to see it, because if I did watch it, and if I was watching it, seeing it as me, I'd just be constantly judging myself. So. Can't have done that.
Were the auditions stressful, or did he just breeze it?
From where we were standing, we tried to make the auditions as easy as possible so nobody felt pressurised. So you try and make it as humorous and as laid back as you can. You try and remind the youngsters that it's not a cure for cancer and it's not the be all and end all. So when you come in, have a laugh. You've got a part in the film, you get it. If you don't, be grateful you didn't get it, and so far as you don't want to be in a film and look like an ass. I'd say, well, it's sort of over you now, bro. I'd say they were really relaxed, the workshops.
They were easy. Auditions and all the workshops were actually what made the film easier as well. The fight rehearsal, like the fight club, all the workshops, they let us kind of meet all the other people that were going to be in the movie. Mm. And that made us kind of get better acquainted. And so by the time we were shooting, we were all close enough to being pals.
I mean, you bring up the fight club there. I'm interested to ask you about how difficult was it choreographing the fight scenes? Because I'm sick to death of these films that glorify gangs. And especially the fight scenes. It's some kind of it's an eroticized thing. Do you purposefully plan out each thing to avoid that, or was it kind of an anarchic?
No, it was both. What we did was it was highly structured so that the kids could improvise within the structure. So two things happened. One, then nobody gets hurt. The one rule we had in Fight Club was nobody should ever land a blow on anybody else. In fact, we told them all, if you do, then we'll fire you, which was bollocks. We couldn't fire them by that time, but they didn't know that. And so when it came to things like the big fight on the bridge, basically, it was very, very simply choreographed, where the kids could, if you like, elaborate on certain choreographed pieces without anybody getting hurt and without reverting to the kind of bollocks that you're talking about, because I hate those scenes also. Not least, it's not even so much that they turn it into kind of pornography of violence, it's because they're so badly executed. It's just stunt guys sticking the head in each other. And it's like, how many fucking headbutts can you get? I mean, the whole point of a headbutt is you don't see it coming. These guys are literally running up with the other guy standing waiting to take it. The whole point of a headbutt was invented is you turn your head to the side because you're letting the other person feel that they're safe. And then you bang, and that way you snap a nose, and it's very unpleasant and very, very painful. You don't walk up to them and say, hello, boom. It's insane. What lunatic's going to stand there and take it? You would break his jaw. And that, as always with these things, when they're badly done, it's not just that, it's not as if it's, one should even elevate it to the level of philosophy. It's just badly executed. It's because you've got lazy directors who basically just think, and they hand it over to stuntmen, and you've got 25 stuntmen beating the crap out of each other, all very skilled stuntmen, but crap actors. And that's the problem, is that you have to, we have to think far more thoroughly about those types of scenes, because when you, that's when it gets fetishized, because it's so unreal, it's ridiculous. And that was something we really strived for in the film, that if there were any scenes of violence, they should be short, sharp, and ugly, which in my experience is normally how violence comes out